So you talked about we talked about the public actually test, and that's one of many transparent steps in our process for running elections. Can you talk about how what other ways there are that someone could either be involved in the process or can observe the process?
Sure. There are many opportunities for people. Some of the more well-known options are first. I would highly recommend that people step up and work as a paid election inspector. Now, the time to sign up to be an election inspector is long before the election, but that is one opportunity. So if people want to learn more about the election process, signing up and working the elections as a paid election inspector is first and foremost the best way to do it. At this point in time, all people can be what's called a poll watcher. So that means in every precinct that there is a designated area where people can come in and just watch the election process. It can be while the polls are opening, it can be all through election day. Each early voting site has a public watching area where someone can come in and just observe the election process. And that's true on election night too. So as long as the precincts are in the process of closing the polls and getting that final paperwork at the end of a long election day done, the public has the right to be in there and observe that process. In addition, they have the opportunity if they want to, they can. There are organizations and the political parties are allowed to have challengers. Now, those are trained and credentialed people who will be in our precincts or early vote sites, AV counting boards throughout the early vote and pre-processing time. But it's another opportunity to peep for people to watch the election administration process. And learn how elections are administered. So that would be one of the options.